Big Mac and lies. Yeah, you get it? Big Mac and fries. I can't lie, I wasn't sure about that because it felt too punny. I didn't want to do anything with a play on words.
I found out my girlfriend was cheating on me while I was bouncing on a trampoline and spotted her over the fence with another man.
What age did this traumatic event occur to you?
I was 18.
So what were they doing next door?
Well, you don't want to know that, either. They were lying, believe it or not, on a trampoline.
You were trampolining in your garden.
Yes.
And you saw over the fence.
Yes.
Into your girlfriend's garden.
No, she didn't live next door.
Oh, right.
Neither lived next door.
Neither of them lived
Correct.
Next door.
Correct.
Oh. Why were they next door,
Because
then?
There was a party going on next door, and it sort of slightly drifted into my house. It was like two sort of houses were taking part in the party. It sort of bled into mine.
What sort of trampoline was it, Lee?
It was the TS-497.
The old trampoline.
I remember jumping up over the fence, seeing them kissing and thinking, is that the TX-417? Where did he get that from? I wish we could afford one of them.
Are we?
Stop kissing her!
I think you know what I mean.
Yes.
Was it an oblong trampoline? Was it the modern one with the nets, the circle with the nets up the side?
Don't say that! Do you know her name was Annette? It was a trampoline with no net round the side.
Oblong or circular?
Well, she'd lost a bit of weight in the... I would say slim to oblong.
So, you couldn't see what was going on except at the top of your bounce trajectory, is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then what do you see for an instant at the top of that bounce? Are they already doing it?
They're not doing it!
Are they already kissing? Are they already writing poetry?
Have they taken their shoes off?
They haven't taken their shoes off.
Ooh!
You know what was more worse, though? It was the only thing they were wearing.
How long had you been seeing her for?
We've been up and down over the years.
So go on, you're at the peak of your trajectory.
Yeah.
Affording you a wonderful bird's eye view of the neighbouring trampoline.
Correct.
What did you see?
I saw my then girlfriend.
Whose name was?
She was called Joanne.
So what happened?
I wanted to have a proper look. I went straight up to the climbing frame. And, sure enough, my fears were confirmed.
Oh, my
It was the TX-497.
You must have been furious.
Oh, I was so angry. I was so angry. So I came round, got on the trampoline, and I went, Joanne! And she looked round, there was no one there. And then I went to the top again, Joanne! She looked round, there was no one there. This carried on for a long time. Joanne! So then I timed it perfectly. I said Joanne when I was down. Joanne! Well, it took a while before I worked out that system.
So what do you think, David? Is he telling the truth?
I don't think so, no.
Why? Can I be honest with you? I'm not convinced either.
Lee, bouncing on the trampoline and spying Joanne. Truth or lie?
It's a lie.
No!
This is my wall map of the UK. I have marked every service station that I have ever visited on it.
Oh, OK.
I can so see him doing that.
Yeah. This from a man who was criticising somebody else for photographing a beige carpet.
Wow.
Sorry, are they little stickers?
Yes. Sorry?
There are two colours of stickers.
There are two colours
what
of stickers.
What do they represent?
The orange ones. These are the orange ones, the orange ones.
Yeah.
And I've also done blue ones.
But why?
Why? So I could differentiate between the two types of service station.
Why?
I'm about to tell you.
OK, well, come on.
Just give me a second.
Sometimes Lee likes to finish his own sentences, sometimes not.
They are basically two differentiating service stations. I use orange if I am heading north and blue if I'm heading south. Or if I'm heading west, I also go for blue. In east, I go for orange.
Well, you have headed north a lot more than you've headed west or east. I mean, how did you get back here?
They're actually equal if you count them.
Looks like there are loads more orange. Now, that one in Scotland there on the top...
I can't believe you know where Scotland is, David. Well done.
Near Inverness has one.
That one there?
That one there. We'd reminisce about that.
Do you know what? I will reminisce about that.
I went in, went through to the main pasty area, where I ordered my Ginster's pasty. And may I say, Aberdeen Service Station, it was absolutely the perfect temperature. This is really hurting my arm.
OK, you can put it down. One more question.
Can we have a look?
You don't have to spoil it with the details.
If you want to have a look, they can have a look.
Can they?
Yeah.
These are all motorway service.
Yeah. Oh, you're all coming, are you?
Well,
I'm
here.
There's an F and an asterisk. What do they denote?
They denote fantastic. And the asterisk is... there's not a word. Blows my mind, the asterisk.
And how many years of touring does this represent?
Oh, it's not just touring. I'll do it when I'm on holiday. I'll do it wherever I go.
You know when you said that there were about the same number of orange and blue? There's 7 blues and 33 oranges.
You're going to be laughing on the other side of your face when in the next round I say, I am colourblind.
So, David, it's time to take a guess.
Aberdeen service station doesn't ring true.
It's definitely... I wonder, with the Aberdeen one, that's right outside Aberdeen. So you stopped at a service station about 6 minutes after departing.
If it's on empty, I stop and fill it up.
Certainly, which 33 times out of 40 happens when heading north.
Yes, it's uphill.
You could... Lie.
You're saying lie quite conclusively. Lee, is it the truth or is it, in fact, a lie?
It is, in fact, a lie.
No.
It's a lie. That's not...
Can I just say to the idiots that come up with these questions, as if it's not hard enough that I put little stickers on a map because I fill up and I like to get... They'll think, oh, no, how can we make it more harder? Well, I have 4 of them with blue on, 1 with an F and 1 with a bloody asterisk. One in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean.
This is my orchidometer. It was a present from my sister.
What does an orchidometer do?
It is a piece of medical apparatus used for determining the size of testicles in male humans.
Yeah. Some of them are so small, they're tiny.
You'd be surprised.
Which one are you? You must have done it.
I've never done it.
You liar!
I've never done it.
Why would I want to? I'll tell you why, because the second we get out of the studio, I'm doing it, so I know. I want to do it now in front of the audience.
Well, do you know what? I think we'd all be very happy for you to do it now.
Let's do it. Have you watched it?
It hasn't been anywhere near any.
Well, don't bring it to me. I don't want to.
Hey, Rob, bring back memories.
Right. I will do it, but I'll do it under the desk.
Are you not going to get your...
Come on.
Warm, just warm then.
Come on then.
No.
What are you going to say?
With your testicle measuring device, you spoil us, Ambassador.
Imagine going to the doctors and going, is that normal to have that many?
Take a look at this, Doc.
Last Christmas Eve, my wife asked me to pop out and get 4 to 5 lemons and 8 or 9 limes. Unfortunately, I misheard her and came back with 45 lemons and 89 limes.
David.
In better news, we haven't suffered from scurvy for a long time.
You went out and you came back with 45 lemons and 89 limes. What did you think they were for?
I don't ever question my wife when it comes to cooking. You just don't... With my wife, she cooks some amazingly overly citrus dishes.
Always.
Well, she's using up what you've bought.
But when you say it was Christmas Eve, were you going to be entertaining guests?
Well, yeah, family members, yeah, so I wouldn't say guests, but they had to come round.
What were the lemons and limes for?
Well, it turns out they were for the drinks. I didn't get any pastry.
I haven't met your wife. I'm sure that she's very lovely and sensible. Why say 4
to five. Why not just say, go and get me five lemons? Go and get me nine limes.
That is exactly what I said when she said, what are you come back with 45 lemons for and 89 limes? Because you're right. You tell me, you know.
Yeah.
Why does she strike me about the head when I wake up? Who knows the mysteries of a relationship?
Where did you get these citrus fruits from, Lee? Was it a corner shop, a hypermarket?
It was a hypermarket on the corner, so it's both.
So you get back home, and there's Mrs. Mack.
Yes.
And what? I mean, when you put your wares on the table, how does she react?
She said, what are they? I said, what do you think they are? Green ones are limes, yellow ones are lemons. She said, how many have you got? I said, I've got 45 lemons and 89 limes. She said, sorry, are you saying 4 to 5 lemons and 8 to 9 limes? I said, no, I'm saying 45 lemons and 89 limes. And
wow.
She said, she went, you're an idiot. I said, what? She went, what am I supposed to do with all them? I said, you tell me, you asked me to buy you 45 lemons and 89 limes. She said, no, I did not. I said, 4 to 5 lemons and 89 limes. I said, sorry, can I just check, what are you saying? She said, I'm saying 4 to 5 lemons and 8 to 9 limes.
So I this said, is when it all became clear?
Yes, yeah, she said, they're for drinks. I said, I know, but your family are alcoholics. And I thought that there was just loads and loads of drinks going to be happening. She went, no, I was going to make something tarty.
I think you'd have laughed about it rather than had a row.
Well, these things always happen in our house. I remember saying to my wife, I only wanted 4 to 5 kids. And now we run an orphanage.
What are you thinking, David?
What do you think?
I just don't believe that she would say, go and get 8 to 9 limes.
Sorry, can I just check? Is it 89 limes or 8 to 9?
I can see it happening. Yeah. I asked my husband once, can you get me 89 Mars bars? And he only got me 8.
What are you thinking, David?
Well, we're saying lie.
You can say lie. OK, Lee, was it truth or was it a lie?
It's a lie! When I was 7, I had to be a bridesmaid at my auntie's wedding. When I was 7, I had to be a bridesmaid at my auntie's wedding, as one of the girls who was supposed to do it was ill, and the dress was a perfect fit.
What did the dress look like?
I described the colour as traumatic.
Why do they have to have a bridesmaid? Why couldn't they just say, if she's not well, let's move on?
I think you're mixing it with admin. Someone says to me, put the dress on, I put it on. You know that, don't you? Do as I'm told.
So you didn't display any reluctance to put the dress on?
I may have said, you know, mother, father, I am a 7-year-old boy. Despite the fact that I am 2 years younger looking and slightly androgynous. But please, give me some dignity.
How much
and my father turned around to me, he said, son, when I was your age, he had a pipe, when I was your age, my father asked me to put a dress on, and I put it on, and his father before him, and his father before him. You'll put me dress on, and you'll smile.
Was there a page boy as well as bridesmaids at this wedding? I was a page boy once, and if another boy had dressed up as a girl, I would have felt it was fair game to persecute him.
Well, true, but luckily the page boy came up to me, little Sharon, and he said, he said, tell me about it. You know, you think you've had a rough day. You know what I mean? I'm a 24-year-old.
How much notice did you get?
Pardon?
How much notice did you get?
Quite a few people. So I think, you know, from memory, quite a few people were,
No,
you idiot.
How much warning? How far in advance?
Oh, I genuinely thought you meant notice. How much notice did you get? That was a genuine one. Yeah. Oh, how much notice
how
did
I get? Oh, everyone thought I was adorable.
I've got to admit.
Oh, I was nervous at first, but then I felt like a princess.
Oh, I see. How much in advance did they tell me?
Yeah, how much notice?
How much notice did I get? Do you know what? That would be embarrassing if this was on television, wouldn't it? I got 5 hours or something. She was ill at the last minute and...
I just think you would have absolutely refused at
Well,
that
listen,
age.
I said, Dad, I don't want to do it. And he went, listen, I'm not your dad, I'm your mother.
constantly calling me dad. The other one, that's your dad.
How long did you have to keep the dress on? At what point in the proceedings? I mean, did you have to wear it right through to the disco and, you know...
My dad said you'll keep it on till the music starts. Da 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 da. Because, unfortunately, the cabaret act had cancelled because of illness.
So what are you thinking, David? Does that sound at all plausible to you?
What do you think, Izzy?
I really want it to be true.
Well, then say true.
I actually think it could genuinely be the biggest load of drivel I've ever heard. It can't be true.
I don't think it's true.
Lie.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Lie. Conclusively, it's a lie. Lee, truth or lie?
It's a lie.
I once took my trunks off in the communal area of a ladies' changing room after getting out of a pool and misreading the signs through my foggy goggles.
David's team.
So, where was the swimming pool?
It was at the leisure centre.
All right.
Where was the leisure centre?
It's next to the swimming pool. It was my local leisure centre.
OK.
Did anyone see your genitalia?
Four people looked, but no-one saw it.
I'm keen to know, at which point were you planning to take off your goggles? When I get out of the pool, I shake off like that.
Yeah.
I turn back, let them have a nice look, and then I put the goggles up. There's no way you'd keep your goggles on for the walk.
Well, I am short-sighted, and they are prescription goggles, and I wouldn't have been able to.
So you were going to wear them home?
Not wear them home, no. I was going to put my glasses on that were in the dressing room.
So the reason you kept the goggles on that stopped you being able
the
to
irony.
See was so that you could see.
The irony.
So you get into the changing rooms.
Yes. Now it's goggles off like that.
Yeah.
And,
so now you can't see anything now.
I can't see a thing.
Yeah.
There was actually no one in the room. It's trunks down like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's when I heard the voice.
And what was the voice?
Hello, I live in your trunks. but that's another story for next week.
No, that's the children's book you're working on. I still feel publishers will be nervous.
So I go in, I do that, I bend over, speedo's down, and...
Is that your technique? Goggles off, pants down. I mean, do you not go to your locker? I would take the goggles off, put them in the locker. I wouldn't go goggles off, pants down, right. Where's my locker?
Was at the locker. No, I was at the locker.
What did the voice say?
The voice said, excuse me. And I said, excuse me, I'm not sure you should be in here.
Did you not question yourself at this point?
Question myself? I questioned her. What are you doing in the men's changing room? I said, Alex, could you say excuse me?
Okay.
I'll show you exactly how it went. Come out here. This is exactly how it went. Right.
Where are we going?
I'll walk you from the... Right, so I've left my child in the pool. Dad will be back in a minute. If they go down, explode.
Can I dry in over here or
You're in the shower, actually. So... Right, I get out of the pool.
At this point, the goggles aren't yet steamed
up. The goggles are on, the furling a bit wet, and I walked in. I'm in there, and then I think, right, and then I look up with my goggles. It's goggles up,
off,
trunks down.
Excuse me?
You're that woman from the one show.
This is the ladies. Get out, you pervert.
I think you'll find this is the men's changing room.
Hang on a minute. No, that's not right. Because if you said that to her, I think you'll find this is the men's changing room and you believed it, then your system would kick back in again. Bam, the pants would be...
Oh, no. I wasn't going to make a point and go, right, come on, then. Beat that! So then the woman said to me, she said, excuse me, I panicked, and I said, I said, excuse me, this is the men's, she says, no, this is the women's, and I thought, for a minute, I thought she was wrong. And then I thought, oh, my God, she might be right. And then another woman came in, and then a third woman. But I'm so argumentative, it wasn't until the fourth woman came in that I considered that I'd made a mistake.
So what do you think? Was he telling the truth there, David's team?
I think it's without question a lie. In fact, if it is the truth, I'm prepared to pull my trousers and pants down right now on this show.
I'm not comfortable with that sort of forfeit becoming part of the format of this game.
So you are willing to say that you are willing to drop your trousers if this is true?
Yeah.
Can we get you some goggles as well?
I don't need them. My eyes will be closed.
I think we're saying it's a lie.
Yes, I'd like
to say that I'm not willing to do anything at all if we happen to be wrong.
So you're
it's
all saying...
It's only a game, for God's sake.
So you say it's a lie. OK. Lee, was it the truth or was it a lie?
It is, in fact, Greg, true. Can I just say that I just whispered, can you change it? Because it was, in fact, a lie.
We once went camping together when we were in the Scouts, and we woke up to find that someone had stolen our tent.
David's team, where to begin?
So when was this camping trip, Lee?
This camping trip was, I would have been about 13, 12, I think, 12.
Something. How old was Steve?
Steve was about, I don't know. He wasn't born.
That's what made the whole thing awkward.
No, he was about seven or eight.
So you were 12 or 13. He wasn't in the Scouts. He was just a 7-year-old you'd brought along.
He was the Cubs and the Scouts went together. He was in the Cubs, I was in the Scouts, and they
asked, and they issued every Scout with a cup.
They did. They put each young boy in with an older boy in each tent.
So where were you camping?
We were camping somewhere in the Lake District. I think it was called the Lake District.
Right. You woke up with no tent, is that what you said?
Correct. Went to sleep with a tent, woke up without a tent.
Do you know what happened to said tent?
Well, that's a good question. We don't know to this day what happened to said tent.
You never saw the tent again?
No, no, no.
Stolen?
Yes, I know it was stolen. We don't know what happened to it.
You don't think it might have blown away? You woke up, no tent, and you assumed foul play.
We weren't that deep asleep that there was a gale force wing.
You were deep enough that someone had stolen the tent.
There's something about wind that's different to burglars.
That's different to burglars. I agree with you.
Wind,
that was what you were asserting, that and that alone, I would say you were telling the truth.
Wind.
However, there's more to this story.
Wind does not sneak up on you.
Can I ask a question? Did this tent not have a built-in ground sheet?
No, it did not. Because otherwise, it would have been, this is Steve and we were once kidnapped.
David's team, is Steve Hugh's caveman, Rufus's pub crawler, or Lee's camping friend?
Lee is definitely the least believable, I think. The other two are quite believable.
Yeah.
No, I don't believe Rufus at all. Rufus has got a bit of edge to him. Steve looks so sweet and presentable. I don't think he'd be in this weird Rufus world.
He does look sweet, does he? Looks like a little cub.
Yeah.
Well, for me, I'm believing Hugh.
I am too. I believe Hugh.
Am I even getting a look in here?
No. And obviously, if it turns out you're true, then super.
You're saying it's Hugh.
Hugh, bat saviour.
OK. So, Steve, would you please reveal your true identity?
Well, I'm Steve. I'm Rufus's best friend. And together, we visited all of the pubs called the Red Lion inside of the M25. Apart from four.
One Saturday morning, I lay on my back in the garden and pretended I'd fallen off a ladder so that I could get out of a family trip to IKEA.
David's team.
What did you been supposedly doing on the ladder?
to fall off it.
So, my wife said we're going to IKEA, and then you should be upset if I said no. So I said, yeah, no problems. Can we go in about an hour? She went, yeah, no problems. Why? And I said, because I've got to do something in the garden. Yeah,
what were you doing?
Trimming the tree.
So you said, OK, we can go to IKEA in an hour. I've just got to go and trim the tree.
I didn't say I'm going to trim the tree, obviously. I said I've just got something to do in the garden.
Why is it so urgent that this tree needed to be trimmed?
You're not following this story, are you, Sean? I didn't need to trim the tree.
Yeah, but surely wouldn't she go, we'll do it later?
Because it was a casual conversation. We're going to IKEA. Can we go in about an hour? I've just got to do something in the garden. She went, yeah, fine. And that was it. Right. We don't live in a relationship where I go, can we go to IKEA? I go, can we go now and do something in the garden? She doesn't sit me down, put a spotlight on me, and go, just a sing in the garden.
OK.
But you did topiary last week!
So you say you've got to do something in the garden. She says, fine. So you walk out into the garden.
Yes.
Go to the shed. Explain how you set the scene.
I go to the shed,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I pick my tool wisely because I want to make sure that when I've fallen with it, that it looks dramatic.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
So what did you pick?
A secateur, nothing. Those big giant ones. Do you know which one I mean? They look like those old-fashioned bull workers, but they've got a pair of scissors at the end.
Yeah. And a telescopic handle.
That's one. I still needed a ladder. They're not going to get me on that.
Do you climb to the top of this ladder?
I don't need to, do I? There's no trimming be done. I mean, are you fucking anyone else? I'm not Robert De Niro. I'm not method. I didn't have to go. I must become the tree trimmer.
Your wife must think you're pretty bad at it if you can go out and presumably instantly fall off the ladder.
I didn't say I fell off instant. I know she's going off to do something else. She says, I'm going to the shops then. So I know she's out. So I position everything.
So she says, in advance of going to this shop, she's going to the shop.
No. It's an expression that people say, I'm just popping to the shops. I pop into the individual shop.
No, it's not an expression. It means going to the shop. Well, is it a euphemism in your house for what? Having a poo.
I pop into the shop. You get me on one letter. All right, I pop into the shop.
She said she was popping to the shop now. Shop singular in advance of your trip to the shop.
She might have said shop. It's one letter. Give me a break. It's series 9. She may have said shop.
Can I ask
or
a question?
Shops. No. I'm just popping out. In fact, she said out. I'm popping out.
She's popping.
She was popping out.
So. OK, so she has left the house.
She's left the house.
So
she's
you
gone
know
to
you've
the
got...
shop. Yeah. to buy a curly whirly or curly whirlies. I'm not sure. She's gone out. I know she's going to be gone enough time for me to get a ladder, lie it on its side, do the second turn, and lie there in a position that I would describe as
Can I ask
injured.
This question? Why didn't you want to go to IKEA?
I think I'd go to IKEA to get out of trimming a tree.
To trim the tree!
So your wife comes back from the shop before going to the shop.
Yeah.
For whatever reason.
And we find that, weirdly, that the different shops sell different things.
Okay.
So I have tried the old one. She goes, I'm just going to buy some potatoes. I've gone, why don't we wait till we're in IKEA? And she said, no, you can't buy. It turns out that different shops sell different things.
So your wife comes back from the potato shop to
find... No, it's not called the potato shop.
You've finished trimming the tree and fallen off a ladder.
Yes.
How much of the tree did you get done?
Did you claim specific injuries that you'd done? When you
said,
oh, I've just generally hurt myself, what? What had you done? What did you say it hurt?
I went, ah! My leg! She went, what's up with it? I said, I don't know, but I can't go to IKEA. And I claim to have injured my coccyx.
How long had she been gone?
It was probably 4 or 5 days this time. I'd say probably about 15 to 20 minutes.
Did she still go to IKEA?
Yeah, no, what did she do then? You're there in agony.
She came to help me.
She helped you up?
She helped me up. She tried to get me stood up. I held the base of my back. Is that what the coccyx is?
Yeah.
I held the base of my back. And she said, you better come inside and sit yourself down. I said, but what about the trip to IKEA? I feel I've let you down. She said, no, that was years ago. I think the bit where I was pushing it, when I shouted, love, can you put that ladder away? I don't want it to go rusty. I might need that in a couple of weeks when we go to Boots.
So what do you think, David? Is this true?
What do you think?
I think it's a lie.
I just think you'd save that for something a bit more...
You think it's a waste?
Yeah, it's a waste of an opportunity to get out of something. like a family dad's... Christmas. You could get out of a whole Christmas.
So what are you going to say?
I think we think it's a lie.
You're saying it's a lie. Lee, truth or lie?
It's a lie. On the first day of my holiday, I lost my glasses, so I was forced to read an entire book through a set of binoculars I found in the villa.
So good, Steve. I've been here all day and I haven't seen you wear glasses.
Well, that's because I wear contact lenses.
Why didn't you wear contact lenses?
Because I didn't take them on that particular holiday.
What was the book?
The book?
Wow.
The Kipper.
By?
Brian Fish.
A book called The Kipper by Brian Fish. I haven't read it or heard of it. What's the genre of this book?
It's a thriller.
Right.
The Kipper was the code name for a sparrow.
Where were you on holiday?
I was actually in Malaysia.
What part of Malaysia?
Coconut Island.
What? Right. What make with binoculars?
I think you'll find I didn't have my glasses. How do I know that? I tried to look through my binoculars to find out, and I even looked into the mirror, but it just wasn't working out, the whole thing. I was like... Yes, because the book had to be a long way away from me.
Well,
otherwise... it's so close to you, when you get to the thrilling bit, it's too scary. So, they got killed! So I have to...
How did you set it up?
The book was at the other end of... We had a little pool in the villa, and it's on the other end of the pool, and I would sit there like that. And then...
How would you turn the pages?
I'd put it down there, and then I'd get up and I'd walk, turn the page, crease it, and back round again.
So, you got there and you'd forgotten your glasses?
Correct.
How did you manage to get there...
Because...
..without realising?
Because I forgot them. I left them somewhere en route.
Right.
But where?
I put them down like this in the taxi. I stepped out for a second. I was literally rubbing my eyes like that. The taxi's gone. I know. Unbelievable. This is the exact word I was thinking of.
You hadn't arrived at your destination.
I took the glasses off for a second like that.
To put them down in the taxi.
But there's a reason I put them down for a second.
Yeah.
Put them down. They're my proper glasses.
Yeah.
To put on my sunglasses when I get out of the car. The sunglasses are prescription.
Yeah.
I step out the car. Yeah. He drives off. I've left the glasses in the back. I can now see perfectly clearly through the sunglasses. I know what you're going to ask me, so I'll just get to that point. During the holiday, I then lost the sunglasses.
Another taxi?
No, I was in the sea.
You're in the sea and what, you put them on a dolphin?
I was in the sea. Well, I didn't know it was a dolphin. I thought it was one of those glasses rests. You know, I just put them down. Oh, I didn't put them down, I put them on. And then I went into the sea, had a little swim, and then a big wave came like that, and went like that. That's not the bit that knocked my glasses off, though. I just up and went, wow, look at that wave. And then I lost it.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to spend the next... Whatever it was, 2 weeks without my sunglasses. So I just
reading a book from one end of a pool to another.
This is it.
With your
how big a book?
It was awful. Even everything was like that. Even the foreplay. I said, go over there so I can have a good look. That's very pleasant, thank you. And then I'd walk over. And she'd say, do I look sexy in this?
I'd be like, hang on. Go back.
So what are you thinking?
Look, I wear glasses. You are so protective of your glasses.
There are various implausible moments in this story. I would say the losing of sunglasses in the sea is not the most implausible. I would say it is the image of Lee sitting at one end of a swimming pool with his binoculars and a book propped up at the other end of the swimming pool. A swimming pool he has to walk round in order to turn the page.
So... You're saying it's a lie?
Well, I would say it was a lie.
I think we're unanimous on that.
All right. So, Lee, truth or lie?
It is, in fact... Where's the button? Tell me when I'm close.
Lie!
This is Marie. She once asked me to pop into her house to get rid of a spider. 10 minutes later, she asked me to leave because I was making matters worse.
All right, there you have it. Ashling's party planner, June's acting apprentice, or Lee's damsel in distress. So, Lee, how do you know her?
Marie lives next door.
Well, she's your next-door neighbour?
Well, she's my next-door neighbour's nanny.
Right, OK.
Not grandmother, obviously.
No.
That'd be crazy.
How big was the spider?
The spider was, including the legs.
Yeah.
The spider was, I would say, about that big with legs.
Well, did she come around and knock on the door, or how did she alert you to the crisis?
She came around and knocked on the door.
And what leaving the children and the spider unattended?
Yes.
And what were you doing?
I was at home just watching television, you know, just like you do, watching a bit of EastEnders, as it goes.
What time of day was this?
7:30 till 8.
So it was in the evening, and Marie knocks at the door. Just you go and answer the door. Yes. What did she say?
She said,
Lee.
She's French.
Okay.
She is. She said, is.
Lee.
You must come very quickly. Pourquoi? I said. There is a spider in my house. I'm very frightened. May we? I said. So I said, I'm not, you know, I'm sort of watching Doc Cotton, my favourite, you know. I don't know this character. I've only just arrived. Last time I was here, it was 3:10. No, so we just made light conversation. Yeah,
made light conversation, despite her distress, despite the fact that she's leaving unattended children in a house with an arachnid she finds terrifying.
Yeah. No.
And so you go in the house.
Yeah.
Where's the spider?
Exactly. La spider, I said. And she said, it's in the bathroom. In the bathroom.
Bathroom.
In the back.
No, that's what I said. I said, no, it's bathroom. She went, oh, thank you, I've learned something.
So it's not.
And then she went upstairs to the bathroom.
Yeah.
And she said, it's under that thing there.
What thing?
There was a little corner cabinet. She goes, it's under there, it's under there. So I said, stand back. But I'm actually a bit frightened of spiders. Mm. So I was trying to play it cool, like I'll sort it out, but was terrified of what I might see. So I asked if she had any like brooms and stuff. She passed me the broom. So I get the stick and I try and move the thing. And as I'm moving the thing, the vase that was on top fell over and smashed. Now, that was just the start of my problem.
Oh, God.
Put it this way. Have you ever seen that episode of Mr. Bean where he tries to catch a spider?
No.
Good. I'll use that then. So, No, so I so the vase smashes. Now the child comes in, sees me. Oh. I panicked, saw the broken vase, saw the child with no shoes on, and just sort of went, whoa, get out, like that. bit too assertively, and the child started crying.
Oh, but why do you make me cry so?
Hang on.
No.
The child is not French.
No, that's what I said. I said, let me finish. I said, are they French children? And she said, no, but you know, the parents are never here, so they learn from me. Unbelievable. 3 years old, never been to France. He's going, boo-hoo, boo-hoo. Why must I cry? Horrible.
What happened then?
She shepherds them out like that. So I got a bit more brave and I went over to the thing like that now and I just go for it. I just pull it like that. The whole thing goes over. The drawer comes out and things spill all over from the top drawer and there's some awkward things in the top drawer because I am in the bathroom that Marie uses. So it's her bathroom. I'm not going to go into detail.
What sort of awkward things?
I don't want to embarrass her.
But a Lee Mack video?
Some awkward things.
And did you at any point actually see the spider?
Well, that's the funny thing. No, I didn't. No,
but
I didn't.
You know what size it was?
Yes, I do. Because she told me. She told me, didn't she?
You described the size quite specifically.
Because I listen to women, Rob. That's the difference between me and you. That's why they go out with me. Because I listen to what they have to say. I don't always go, did you see me and Gavin and Stacey? No. I'm interested in their lives, Rob. In their lives. And their fears. It's not all about you.
All right, well,
is Marie Aisling's party planning friend, June's acting apprentice, or Lee's damsel in distress?
Well, I'm pretty sure that Lee doesn't listen to women. No. So but what do you think?
What Lee's saying is obviously... it's just not true, is it?
Yeah.
Doc Cotton, the motorbike years. No, I ask, no.
Aisling's absolutely sold me on this. I can see you struggling with that banana. It's unquestionably.
What do you think?
Marie looks Irish as well. There's something about her that's Irish.
OK. Think it's the stripper story.
You think it's Aisling? OK. Marie, would you please reveal your true identity?
Sorry.
Je m'appelle Marie et I booked a stripper for Aisling's birthday.
Genuinely for a moment then I thought, oh, it is me.
You're not French, are you?
No. I just really wanted that story to be true.
We are not going out.
Scary knowing the only thing separating me from death is one single plank.
There's a good few inches of wood there.
I wasn't talking about the boat.
Neither was I.
Here, let me do that.
Oh!
Fine. Do you know what? You win. I now declare this marriage.
Get the ring off. Oh, God.
I'm swelling.
Can we get an actress with less chubby fingers?
Oh, do you know what? Fine. You win, then. Oh.
We've changed the ring. We're all right. Okay. Luckily, somebody had a bulldog's collar, and we're going to try it.